Okay, so check it out. The RTX 3080 Ti. I've got it here in my hand, but I think that many users out there, including myself, are going to be pretty disappointed with this release, and I'm here to tell you why. So let's just jump right in and talk tech. Did you just build yourself a brand new PC? Or did you just upgrade your old PC, but find you're in need of a Windows 10 key? If that's the case, your CD key has you covered. And buying, it's never been easier. All you do is go to the Your CD Key website, find the Windows software that you want to buy, put it into your cart, enter the code TOT20, apply the code, save yourself some extra money, and as soon as you complete your purchase, the Windows 10 key will be in your inbox. There's no problems, it's really easy, and all keys are guaranteed to work, so you don't have to worry about losing your money, and you'll have a valid Windows 10 key to get your unit up and running. Okay, so the 3080 Ti. Usually, I spend days benchmarking this car, doing all kinds of crazy stuff, and this time, honestly, after watching all the reviews on launch day, I just decided to kind of forego that. I'll put some links down below to some other people who did some crazy testing. Right now, I'm in my wheelchair, and it was actually really hard to get to all that stuff. But I do have a lot of key points that I want to talk to you guys about this particular card, because there are just some things about it that I'm not the kind of side who has enough clout to really go and, you know, kick Nvidia squarely in the balls and expect them to keep sampling me, but I can also neither like say really great things from what I've been reading about this particular card. Now, all my testing and stuff I'm going to do this weekend, but I don't really see how it's going to be much different than anybody else's testing. So first of all, let's just talk some things about the card. So when the 3080 came out, it was about $700 coming to the market. This particular card is $1,200. $1,200. Now, I've watched a bunch of reviews from a lot of different people around the web, and one thing that is definitely being shown is that this particular card is only at the absolute maximum fastest about 13% faster than a 3080. Okay, 13%. Mostly it seems like it's between 2 and 5% faster than a 3080. Now that in itself wouldn't be such a bad thing. But the problem is, however, is that this card is costing 70% more than a 3080. So a 3080 Ti that you're only getting about 13% at the max, 5%, you know, is the general, for almost double the cost. I just can't really honestly, as a reviewer, recommend this card to people to go buy at that particular price point. I mean, if you're going to pay almost double for a card, then that card should have a lot more performance value than what we're seeing in the benchmarks around the web. Seriously, at least 50% more if you're gonna pay almost double. You're basically paying like hundreds and hundreds of dollars for just a few frames per second more on the card. Now, with the 3090, with the 20 gigabytes of RAM that were on it versus the 12 gigabytes of RAM that are on this particular card, I mean, you could do a lot of different things. You could either be rendering stuff, or you could be, you know, using it to work with 3D, you know, imaging type of software and stuff like that. But with a 12 gigabyte card, you're gonna be sacrificing quite a bit. So you've got this card now that's not quite a 3090, which honestly, I mean, most reviewers out there, including myself, really never recommended this as a pure gaming card. It played games, sure, but at the cost and everything it was geared for, it really wasn't per se a gaming card. It fell into the gaming series, but it was a card more made for workstation and that type of stuff. And that card is honestly going for phenomenal prices as we see across the board. Plus, here's the other issue right now. If we were in any other type of environment than the one that we're in right now, I don't really see how Nvidia would really even have the balls to charge $1,200 for a card that's just not that faster than the 3080. I mean, that to me is what's really the most mind-boggling thing and what kind of got me just kind of like hang back, hold on to my card and go, well, you know, maybe I should just wait a few days and see what happens, because what I'm seeing so far is, once again, there's no stock. So you've got a card that's very expensive. There's no stock. Oh, I mean, the box is smaller, however, than the previous generation box. I will say that. The box got smaller. The card, however, and from other reviews of you guys have seen, looks exactly the same pretty much as the previous generation cards. All of the same features, DLSS, Ansel, all the things that have to do with it with any Nvidia card are all still there. The thing is, how many people are going to want to shell out $1,200 for a card that's barely faster than their $700 variant? Now, that's a very important factor, because when you take in, you know, the cost ratio versus performance, I'm just not seeing the 3080 Ti fall within that category whatsoever. And I think that a lot of reviewers out there around the world actually feel the same way about this particular product. I mean, it's just crazy. Let's just face it. I mean, if the card would have come to market at maybe a couple of $100 more, even like say $999, I don't think they'd be getting so much flack as a card coming to market at $1,200. Now, the other thing is, we all know how this market has gotten lately. We all know how it's gotten. The cards will come out, the scalpers will grab them, the miners will grab them, we'll all be just holding our head going, oh my God, can I even get a hold of a card? And then you're gonna see them on eBay selling for like $25,000 to $3,000. And that's pretty much how the trend has been. Now, I'm not really sure if Nvidia is just trying to play the middleman in their own cards, figuring, you know, hey, you know, all kinds of other people are gonna collect the money on this, so why should we not? But I don't really think that Nvidia should really be doing that. I mean, Nvidia has so far said that they're trying to support the gaming community, but with things like this, it's hard really to see that. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I have a lot of friends who work at Nvidia. There are people there who I respect and love, who I've been friends with for many years. But even for me, when I got the card, looked at all the reviews on launch day, looked at the pricing and everything after the event, I was just like, because I just don't really see the logic behind it. This card should have been cheaper, for one thing. Availability, I mean, I can't really totally target Nvidia as a target for availability, because, you know, it's not their fault the pandemic came around that so many people are at home just, you know, wanting to game. That's not really their fault. But the thought process on this particular card and its release, to me, is not something that I would really think that is something they should really be doing at all. $1,200, not much availability, 70% higher cost than the previous generation card, with only 13% maximum value as far as the performance goes. I mean, do you guys really want to see a bunch of more graphs with numbers on them? I mean, the fan signature is the same according to other sites. The card is quiet. Only when you overclock it, when the fan speeds up, does it make any noise. This is the same thing we've seen on all the other cards that have come out in the RTX series, so nothing's really changed there. The only thing we're seeing is 12 gigabytes of RAM, GDDR6X memory, a little bit of a faster clock speed, and a price that's nearly double what the previous generation was. I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you guys think Nvidia really dropped the ball on this particular launch, especially with the pricing I feel that they have on this particular card? Now, other launches are coming up. Hopefully they won't see such a drastic, I don't know, variance? I guess the word I'm looking for, a drastic, I'll just use that word. Drastic, it fits, right? It's drastically overpriced, drastically underpowered, and drastically not in stock. I mean, really? I mean, do you guys really want to see more and more reviews on cards that you can't get that are really overpriced and not what the market's wanting? I don't think you do, and that's why I kind of waited on my video and just wanted to give you guys my particular take on this particular launch. I feel that the 2080 Ti launch at this point, even though for Nvidia it probably won't be a fail because there's no cards out there, so people are going to pay this price anyways and buy the cards, But I don't think it's a good thing or a good face to put on to your public to be like this. And this is the very first time I felt so strongly about any Nvidia release in this negative a fashion. Usually I can be like, oh, okay, the card is really, really fast, or it's this, or it's that, or it's that, but I can't find anything with this particular launch. So therefore, I didn't really feel like going through all the hoops just to bring you guys the same information about this little card right here that's out there all over the net. So I don't know. What do you guys think? Do you guys want me to full-on blown test this thing and show you guys a bunch of graphs just to hear the benchmark song? I mean, I'm down. Or, after watching all these other reviews out there on the net, do you guys agree with my opinion that this card is overpriced, underpowered, and out of stock? What more is there really to say about that? Because my job as a reviewer is to bring you guys the results so that you can go out and make a buying decision. And I cannot recommend this card as a gamer to any of my fellow gamers because of the price, performance, and everything else. So that's all I'm gonna say about this particular card. Peace out. If you wanna see the full review, you want me to do all that stuff and see the benchmarks, hey, leave a comment down below. I'm willing to go through all the hoops. But as it is right now, I'm kind of waiting for the next release and hoping that it's a little bit better than this one. Like usual, I will have links down below. Hey, if you like what you see on the site, then hey, please sub and hit that little notifications bell and you'll see me making more videos, because I'm going to try to make more videos this month than I've made in a long time. Even though I'm in a wheelchair, I'm sick. I even had surgery in my foot this morning, so I was throwing up all day long. Just even getting in front of the camera to do this was like a strain. I kept going, okay, am I gonna stop throwing up long enough to do this? But I was able to. So let me know your opinions. You guys are the audience. I appreciate you. Do you guys agree? Just bringing one more review about this card when there's already so many out there, I don't find it's necessary, because I can already pretty much tell you what's up with it just from everything I've seen. Do you agree? Let me know. Peace out.